Use the Theorem of Pappus to find the exact volume of a torus shown below. Assume the disk or circle of radius a equals 3 inches is positioned with the left end of the circle at b equals 8 inches and is rotated about the y-axis. So we know the radius of the circle, this red circle, is equal to 3 inches. And we know the left edge of the circle is 8 inches from the axis of rotation, or the y-axis. So we know b equals 8. And now let's review the Theorem of Pappus. Let R be a region in the plane, and let L be a line in the plane that does not intersect the region R. In our case, the region R is the circle, and the line L is the y-axis. Then the volume of the solid of revolution formed by revolving R around L is equal to the area of R multiplied by the distance d traveled by the centroid of R. Which means to determine the volume, we first have to determine the area of the circle, and then we have to determine the centroid of the circle, which is simply the center of the circle, and then determine the distance d the centroid travels when rotated about the y-axis. Let's begin with the area of the region R, which is the area of the circle. We know the area of a circle is pi r squared. In our case, r is equal to 3 inches, and therefore the area of r is equal to pi times the square of 3, which gives us 9 pi square inches. We want exact values because we want the exact volume of the torus. Next, we need to determine the centroid of the circle, which is simply the center of the circle. Notice the x-coordinate of the center of the circle is 8 plus 3, or 11, and because the center is on the x-axis, we know the y-coordinate is 0. Next, we determine d, which is the distance the center of the circle travels when rotated about the y-axis. Notice that would be the distance around a circle with a radius of 11. Recall the perimeter of a circle is called the circumference of a circle, which is equal to 2 pi r. So d equals 2 pi r, where r is equal to, again, the distance from the origin to the center of the circle, which is 11 units, which gives us 2 times pi times 11, which equals 22 pi inches. And now we can determine the volume. The volume of the torus is equal to the area of r times the distance d, which gives us 9 pi times 22 pi, which equals exactly 198 pi squared cubic inches. And again, the question does ask for the exact volume. Just in case you're curious, the approximate volume is 1,954.18 cubic inches. I hope you found this helpful.